Hey, good morning. I pray you're doing well. I wanted to just touch on one more thing. I know there's a lot of new viewers, and I want to share a few things. We do see that the mark of the beast has been going out over the past couple years. We do know that there's new information about the next phase of that coming. The next phase about what's been in the news lately and what's been going on in Christian circles, but nonetheless, we do know that the mark of the beast has been going up because the mark is not only a spiritual mark, but also it is a mark of a changing of how the Father created each individual here on earth. It's a changing from the image of the Father into the beast's image, because once you take the mark, you are actually part of the beast system. When we look at the book of Revelation, chapter 6, it talks about the first four riders. Now, we do see and we do know that we're currently at the third rider, the third seal. We do know that the first rider brought a toxin. And again, I'm referring to everything in the original language. And I challenge you and encourage you to look into the original language on each and everything I speak of. The interpretations have been not that great. Once it gets translated into English, the first rider brings a toxin. We see that going out, and the toxin actually has a name of a crown, and that crown is the name of Corona. It's a toxin named Corona. We do know that it's implemented by a sharp sword of the Red Rider, the second seal. He has a sword. When you look in the original language, it's a sharp pointed instrument. We do see the rider on the black horse, which is the third seal. We do see that there's hyperinflation. That is going on right now. Let's focus on not just the U.S., but around the world. We see hyperinflation taking place, and we see it taking place here in the U.S. as well. We see famine going on. We see pestilence going on. So the rider on the black horse is bringing famine and hyperinflation. But if you notice, it says that those who are sealed in Christ, the oil and the wine, the oil, the Holy Spirit, the wine, the blood covenant of those who have partaken in the oil cannot be harmed, the oil and the wine. We do see at the fourth seal, which I believe is when the rapture takes place, is when hell and death are released upon the earth. Jesus Christ holds the keys of hell and death. He's allowing them to be released. Once hell and death are released upon the earth, I believe that's when the rapture takes place. And again, go back through my videos and why I believe this. I believe the fourth, fifth, and sixth seal happen simultaneously. So please go back and take a look at that. But do know this, we are definitely in the book of Revelation. We are definitely at the third seal. So please, again, I encourage you to please warn others. When hell and death are released, death is going to come. It's going to come by famine of the third seal, by pestilence of the first seal, by the sword of the second seal. If you look in the original language, it's by the wild beasts of the earth. The wild beasts are those who have taken the toxin, taken the mark of the beast, and are no longer human in the eyes of God. That is why when Joshua was going through the promised land, he was destroying every civilization. They were not human. Their DNA was altered. Go back through my videos and take a look why that took place. Why do we see everything going on right now? It is so important. Our eyes are opened. We're at the third seal. I believe the fourth, fifth, and sixth seal happen simultaneously. The fourth seal is about to take place. We're almost home, guys. Focus on Jesus Christ. It's in His precious and holy name, Yeshua the Messiah, I pray. Amen. Bye-bye.